Hi, I'm Carmen Law, also known as Fabric Jia. I'm an illustrator from Malaysia. Today, I'm going to show you my rendering techniques and some of my brushes and brush settings that I frequently use. If you want to learn more about me and my creative process, you will find the link to my Domestika course in the description below. Let's work on the hair tip. I will first select the hair tip with lasso tool. Now, let's erase the bottom part with a soft brush. Let's select the eraser tool. Because I don't have a brush preset for the eraser tool, so I will just use one of the default Photoshop soft round brush here. Let's set the opacity to around 50%. Now, let's use the brush tool to paint in the hair tip. For the hair tip, this is the brush that I love to use. I think the brush strokes are too transparent and I want it to be more opaque. So I will go to the brush setting and turn off the opacity jitter here. I'll undo this. Now, I will switch to another brush for more details. I will use this brush. Again, I think this is too opaque and the texture details are gone. So, let's turn the opacity jitter on again for this brush. Now it looks much better. I change my opacity jitter based on my personal preference on different brushes. You do not need to follow my settings. So feel free to play with the settings and adjust it to fit your own preference. Another technique that I like to use to create hair with soft and hard edges is, I will first make a big stroke. Then, I will use the eraser to erase one side. Let's use a soft round brush eraser. I will repeat this step and keep adding new layers on top of each other until I get a result that I like. After that, I will merge them all together. Let's rename it again. Now, let's add more details to the hair. I will first talk about another setting that I change frequently, which is the minimum diameter in Shape Dynamics. Let's click brush. The minimum diameter under Shape Dynamics. The minimum diameter here lets you set a limit for how small the brush stroke can get. You can see it from the preview here. Normally, I like to set the minimum diameter to 50%, but when it comes to adding small details like the hair strands, I will set this to very low or 0% so that it will have a smaller end. You can see the result in the preview here. Let me show you. Now let's deselect the hair tip and let's add more hair strands. Now let's work on the eyelashes as well. Let's work on the hairline as well. Now, I think I want to add more shadow under the hair here. Remember how we choose a shadow color? First, color pick the skin color. Make the saturation higher, make the brightness lower. Set the mode to multiply. Let's put some shadow around the hairline as well to make the transition looks more natural. Let's add more shadow under the chin as well. Now, I want to check my portrait by flipping the canvas. Image, image rotation, flip canvas. Now, I've noticed there is some small adjustments that I need to make. So, to make the adjustments, I like to use the liquify tool. Let's go to filter and select liquify here. This window will pop up and let you adjust the shapes. I will use the first option here. It's called the forward warp tool. After we are satisfied with the changes, we will click OK. Let's flip the image back. I will add the eye color for her. Let's zoom in. Select the soft round brush. You can also use any brush that you like to use. In the image reference, she has green eyes. I think I will give my portrait the same green eyes. To pick the color, I will first go to the hue slider here and move it to green color area. The eye color looks medium saturation, so I will put medium saturation here. And it looks very dark, so I will reduce the brightness a lot. Let's try it here to see. Right now, our color is still too bright, so we will reduce the brightness even more. We will adjust the sliders until we get the result that we like. Now I think this looks fine. It's black color in the middle of her pupil. And there's also some very dark edge. Let's add more shadow beneath the eyelid. So first, we'll select, let's say the skin color here. For darker color, increase the saturation, decrease the brightness. The mode, set to multiply. Now let's add some reflection light to the eyes. Let's set the brush back to normal. Select the color here. For reflection, it will be slightly brighter and low saturation. Let's refine the eyes a bit more. Now let's give the same specular highlight they have here to our portrait. To do that, I will pick the semi-hard round brush. This looks white color to me. Just pick a white color from the color wheel. Let's add some highlight around her face as well. Now, I think the eyes are slightly too big. I will adjust the size in liquify again. Now, let's go to filter and click liquify. Previously, I've showed you how to modify the drawing using the forward warp tool here. Now, I will show you how to enlarge or reduce the size of an object. For example, now I want to make the eye smaller. To do that, I will select the pucker tool here and I will click on the eyes until I get the result I want. Next, I want to make her lips bigger. To do that, I will select the bloat tool. Let's click on the lips until we get the result that we want. Now I'm satisfied with the result and I will click OK here.
If you like the content, subscribe to this channel And if you want to learn more about how to create a portrait with fantasy elements in Photoshop, check out my online course on Domestika.